MLB The Show is your home for postseason baseball. It's Game 3 of the American League Division Series between the New York Yankees and the Tampa Bay Rays. Hi again, everyone. Matt Vaskirjian. Welcome to our special postseason coverage of Baseball on the Show. With me is Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac. And Dan, lots to talk about here as we get ready for Game 3.
And you got to figure here in a five-game series, the odds are long for coming back when you're down 2-0. But hey, it's not impossible. It's been done before, but you can bet the other guys are hungry to end this thing right here and now to give themselves a couple of days off before the next series. This should be a good one.
The postseason is officially in full swing. Lineups and first pitch coming up next. Tyler Glasnow will do the pitching in Game 3 of the series. What do we need to know here, Danny?
This guy has a three-pitch mix, and he needs all three of his pitches. If he has them all working and uses them properly, he has a chance to be very effective.
And that sends DJ LeMahieu into the box. And we are set for baseball here this evening. Two balls and a strike down to the Yankees leadoff man. And this will miss as well, so he's in danger of losing the leadoff man here tonight. It's 3-1 now. Pitch on the way. And it's up to a 3-2 full count now.
He must know something we don't know. That was a center cut heater with count leverage in a big spot. I don't understand why he stayed.
And he lays off ball four, and the leadoff man is on to begin the ball game. Next for New York, Aaron Judge. First chance for him here with a man on following the leadoff walk. The pitch down and away, ball two.
Boy, not exactly what you'd like as a pitcher. One of the keys is to minimize your pitches, attack the strike zone early, a lot of deep counts, and working himself into a lot of trouble.
Swing, and there it goes. Deep to left field. And this ball is gone. No chance. Aaron Judge, a two-run shot, his second home run of the series, and this is now a 2-0 lead for the Yankees.
Well, people always wonder why some players make so much money, and there's your answer. The great ones find a way to rise to the occasion in the postseason, and he did right there.
In now, Aaron Hicks.
Outside,
and this ball runs away for ball two. 2-1. His previous line with Tyler Glasnow. He's 1-for-3. All even now, 2-2. Now here's the pitch. Chopped weakly to the left. Bases are empty here. Nobody out. 3-2 to the Yankees center fielder.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
Now the payoff pitch home. Here is a ground ball now for the shortstop to the right of second. On the first, so a good bounce back pitch there as he gets the ground ball for the first out. Next will be the designated hitter, Giancarlo Stanton. Got him swinging, chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone.
Big curveball for the strikeout there, and that came after an absolute missile of a fastball. Even if you recognize the breaking ball out of the pitcher's hand, it's so hard for hitters to sit back long enough after they've seen a really good fastball. Only the best can keep their hands back on those.
Standing in now, Luke Voit. Just behind the fastball there, two strikes now.
Hey, I know it's early and we're in the first right here, but he's going to have to work that heater to both sides of the plate. He cannot get away with missing over the heart of the plate all night.
He loses him on ball four.
Some guys take a little time to find the zone, but with the second walk of the first inning, it might be a little more than just settling in. Not sure how long of a leash they'll give him, but they're not going to let him walk the world out there.
Next up will be Gleyber Torres. His previous meeting line with Tyler Glasnow. He's a 333 hitter. And that one misses badly. It's ball two. Not close with that one. It's way above the strike zone.
That's a good take on a fastball out of the zone. Hey, I get it. He's looking for a ball to drive, but that ball was a little bit too far up in the zone. That's one you normally pop right up.
Now the payoff pitch home. And he misses again. Ball four. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on ball.
Well, it's that earlier home run he gave up that's still on his mind. He had him 3-2, but he didn't want to give him anything over the heart of the plate to hit, so we'll see if that walk comes back to hurt him.
Into the box, Clint Frazier. And the Yanks trying to make this first inning even sweeter here. And a curveball is by him that time as he falls behind now, 1-2. And the 32nd pitch of the inning is swung on and missed, and that will retire the side. Yankees get a couple on the two-run home run. On to the bottom of the first. It's now 2-0 New York. Jameson Taillon is on the mound, and he'll look to wrap up this division series. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Matt, we're getting a chance to see a very talented right-hander here in Jameson Taillon. His stuff has always played well. It's just a matter of staying lucky and staying healthy. This guy has what it takes to be a solid major league pitcher.
Ready now is Austin Meadows. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. 1-1. Early swing there as he pulls it foul to the right side. Here comes the 1-2. Bounce it to the left side, but that finds its way through for a base hit. Throw into second. The tag, and he is out at second.
The second baseman, Glanville.
So now to the plate, Brandon Lau. Way outside, nearly to the backstop, 2-1. Into right field, that's a base hit. Boy, that line drive was a blur off the bat. Which
which means it's definitely worth looking at on show track. And how about this for an exit velocity? 116 miles an hour. That's right up there with the fastest we've seen. At the plate, Randy Arozarena.
Oh, that's
it. Inside here with the hard stuff, and it's 2-1 now. Pitch is popped up.
LeMahieu
is under it, and he brings it in for the second out of the inning.
Batting four.
And with two away now, we give you another glance at our up-to-the-minute playoff bracket. And here in this game three of the division series, the big question is, will we see a sweep? Runner at first with two gone, and that brings up the corner infielder G-Man Choi. The 3-2 pitch, and it's fouled away. One more time, fouled away. Once again, a 3-2. Inside with a fastball, and he works the base on ball.
He did not want to let the hitter off the hook with two outs, and now he's got a runner in scoring position.
So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Manuel Margot. The set and the 1-1 pitch. Called strike, 1-2. And the slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball.
Now 2-2, two on, two out. This is when you have to make a pitch right here. The last thing you want to do is run the count full to 3-2. Then the runners are going to be off to the races.
Working for the punch out and the offering. In the dirt. Throw over to third here. And oh, they say he beat the throw. Safe at third. Again, ball four. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on ball.
Well, this guy's been prone to giving up walks at bunches, and that's already two walks here in the early going. We'll see if this continues to be an issue for him as this start continues.
Joey Wendell digs in now. The base knock to the outfield could score the tying run from second. Lau at third. Choi on second. Margot on at first with two down. Swinging a soft liner. On to first, and the Rays are kept off the scoreboard here as the side is retired. A couple of walks in the inning, but nothing on the scoreboard. We'll have more of game three after this message. Second inning set to go, and that'll give way to the third baseman, Gio Urshela.
I'm interested to see how focused their ABs will be playing with this lead. I think this needs to be a little bit of a smell blood inning. Keep the fire rolling. I know it's early, but keep the pressure going. Swinging the bat's nice.
Swing and a liner toward the gap in left center. And this is into the alley and ought to be good for extra bases. This will kick up against the wall now. And he is in the second base with a leadoff double.
He just tattoos this ball right here. Tried to sneak a fastball in on him? No way. Drives it to deep left center field gap, and that was a nice job to get the barrel around in time to score that baby up.
In into the box, Gary Sanchez. Hit the target, but this is low, 2-1. His previous meeting line with Tyler Glasnow. He's gone 2-for-8. He's also gone down on strikes 5 times. The 2-1.
Well, we don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Now the payoff pitch home is swung on and missed. He got him.
Pretty textbook breaking ball for the punch out right there. Got it to bend a lot, and by the time it got there, it had fallen completely out of the zone. Not much you can do with that pitch.
Chase a pitch that bad outside the zone, you got to find a way to regroup, adjust the batting gloves, only look over the hard in those 17 inches.
Here comes the 1-2. Hit back up the middle. Adames scoops it up. Throw in time at first for out number 2. Judge. And remember, he hit that 2-run homer his first time up.
And that's been the entire offense so far in this one. They've been shut down other than that.
Well, they'll run this one in on him, and he can't connect, so he finds himself down 1-2 now.
Oh, I love that pitch right there. Up and in. Jam sandwich.
Lays off it to even the count 2-2.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off-speed pitch in the dirt.
Into the corner and slicing foul. A 2-2 one more time. And he fouls this one off. Swing and a miss. Blew the fastball right by him, and the inning is over. The Yanks lead 1. They're up 2-0. Leading off the inning, it'll be Willy Adames as they'll look to spark the offense and even things up. Here comes the 1-2. Is a wave and a miss. He struck him out.
Talk about blowing it by a guy. Jeez, I mean, that fastball was way behind him when the swing came through the zone. I have to think he was looking for something off speed, and he just couldn't pull the trigger on that fastball.
Into the box now, Kevin Kier. And he struck him out as well. So the bottom of the order providing little resistance here, and there are 2 away.
Boy, that's really disappointing for a guy that has wheels, right? All he wants to do is get on base and take advantage of the strength of his game, which is his speed. But with the strikeout right there, you can't get on first base if you strike out.
To the plate now, Mike Zunino. And that one misses badly. It's 2. Bases are empty here with 2 men out. Starts to go around here, but it doesn't matter. This is 2 anyway. Fly ball out toward left center field. Hicks is under it. He handles it easily, and the inning is over. Down in order go the Rays. They're still down. It's 2-0.
Welcome back to Miami as we check in with Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with Yankees manager Aaron Boone during the break about the team's performance so far, and flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats.
They've already worked out three walks, so he feels as though that kind of willingness to let the opposition work themselves into trouble will continue to result in good things for them on the scoreboard.
Good stuff, Heidi. Thanks. Digging in now for the Yankees, Aaron Hicks. He bounced out last time up. The 2-2. Fouled off. The 2-2 one more time.
Count it 3-2.
You can certainly tell at bats like this one frustrate the heck out of a pitcher. But you got to find a way to stay composed and execute your plan.
Now the 3-2 pitch. There's a swing and a drive hit well out to right field. Margot's going back. On the warning track, he makes the catch. Giancarlo Stanton now. Bases are empty, one man out. Maybe a little jumpy there as he swings through the fastball.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
Kiermaier calls off the left fielder as he takes charge for the second out. Stepping in next, Luke Voit worked a walk his first time up. Two out, nobody on. Two balls and a strike to the Yankees' first baseman. Ripped down the first baseline, but that finds its way through for a base hit. And now it'll kick around in the corner. And now he'll get into scoring position with two away.
Now batter, the shortstop.
Standing in now, Gleyber Torres. Could have been 3-1. Instead, it's 2-2. Now a ball ripped into deep center field. And nothing will come of the two-out double as the inning is over. Two-out double left stranded. Back with more from Game 3 after this. For the last half of the inning, and striding forward, the designated hitter, Austin Meadows. Look out as his bat shatters on impact. Off balance throw, but he couldn't get enough on it, so it'll be scored as an infield single.
I know that has to be frustrating from a pitcher's standpoint, but nice execution, nice hustle. Bottom line, nice hustle. Pitcher's still one good pitch away from getting a double play.
You know, D-Roll, one of the things you want to do is make quality pitches as a pitcher. And there's not much you can do right there. You make a pretty good pitch, and the next thing you know, you have a single on an infield ground ball.
And now, Brandon Lau. He lays off upstairs, but it's ruled a strike, and he can't believe it. 1-2. Fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning. Got him with a good high fastball there. Danny, we see a lot of that pitch in strikeout situations these days. What makes it so effective?
I think, Matt, what makes it such a tough pitch is you're changing eye levels. That fastball up looks so enticing to hit that you think you see that ball as a hitter. You think you can drive it, but it's really hard to get on top of that good high hard fastball.
No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence. He's got great body language on the mound. He's got fastball and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
that. Here's the 2-2. And it's fouled away. High in the air out to center field. And Hicks will settle under this one for the second out. So two down and a runner at first, and that brings up the corner infielder G-Man Choi. Meadows, the runner at first with two gone. This one sinks low and a touch outside. It's a full count, 3-2. Manuel could be next. Out of the stretch, the 3-2 pitch home. Strike three called, and the inning is over. One left for Tampa. They trail it here 2-0. All set for the start of the fourth, and that'll bring up the outfielder, Clint Frazier. Fastball didn't miss by much, and it's a full count now, 3-2.
Well, the 1-2 pitch didn't go his way, and now a miss there on 2-2. You know he doesn't want to get away from, so I think we're going to see a challenge pitch on a full count.
Lifted into the air to shallow center. Kiermaier coming on. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning. In Giovanni Urshela, one for one as he reached base with a double his first time up. Two runs, three hits, and no errors for the Yankees so far. This pitch is popped up, and he'll put this away for the second out. So next to hit is Gary Sanchez, looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at bat.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
Pitcher 2-2 now. I think it's safe to say he wasn't ready for the fastball.
Wow, was he behind that fastball. Great job on the mound using the curveball to set up the heater.
And they could go either way now, I suppose. Now a fastball inside, and he works it back to a full count now. Both clubs with three hits in the ballgame. Hit sharply on the ground. And the inning will continue as that's through for a two-out hit.
Hey, D-Row, that's just what you want to do. Keep the pressure on. He's given up a couple of runs early already in this game, and now he gives up the two-out single.
Yeah, no chance right there. You want to make this guy work. You want to try and get into their pen as quick as possible. And if two-out knocks are the answer, then so be it.
So now to the plate, DJ LeMahieu. Open to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Misses. Ball two. Runner on first with two away. Well above the letters with the fastball that time.
Well, this has been a good at bat. He's now worked the count full to 3-2. It allows the runner on first to be on the move with two away.
It's a ball four. So that's going to move a runner into scoring position now with two away.
Well, he made quick work of the first two guys this half inning, getting two quick outs, but then he gives up a base hit and now the walk. We'll see if he has it in him to draw the line in the sand and get out of this.
Cody Reed answers the call from the pen here in the fourth. They didn't get the outing they were hoping for from the starter. Aaron Judge be his first assignment here as he'll face him with runners at first and second and two away. for a base hit. Long throw to the plate. And he's going to score with ease as the throw will be too late.
Boy, this guy's having a great game here so far, Nero. Home run earlier in the night, and that base hit right there drives in his third run batted in.
Yeah, you drive to the park every day hoping your rhythm and timing is on point with that pitcher's windup. And that's exactly been the case today. He not only mixed in that big bomb, but now he's got three ribbies to boot.
Stepping in now, Aaron Hicks. And that misses 2-1.
Great chance right here as a hitter to be really aggressive. With two guys already on, pretty good shot. He's going to get a challenge pitch right here.
Hard hit ball to second. A diving effort as it's off his glove. But the recovery will come too late, and the bases are loaded now. Into the box now, Giancarlo Stanton. Easy take there on the sinker, well off the outside.
Well, things are bad enough as it is right now. One run in, base is juiced, and now he's falling behind the count. You can bet the guy at the plate is thinking about making this a five-run inning in a hurry.
Ready with the 2-1.
It often becomes harder to hit the zone when the pressure starts to heat up.
Here's the 3-1. Looks like he swung it underwater that time for strike two.
You have to find a way to lay off that low sinker. There is just no way to do any damage. You're just looking at either a bruise.
Here's a fly ball. Well hit. Gone! It's a grand slam! So he promptly unloads the bases with that one. His third home run of this series as this lead swells to 7-0.
Man, that has to hurt. He was one pitch away from getting out of the inning without the wheels coming completely off. But guess what? Now this thing is stripped and on blocks.
Into the box, Luke Voigt. This one's outside. Quite a bit off the plate that time.
Somebody's getting frustrated. He's not used to getting hit around like this.
Now the 2-1.
I got 3-1. Three balls.
For his career in this matchup, not a big sample size, 0-1. Strike two on a well-placed changeup around the knees.
3-2.
Hit down the third baseline. And this will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2. A payoff pitch one more time. Back up the middle, right to him. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. But one more look at the big blow in the inning for the Yankees. A grand slam home run. Bottom of the fourth coming up. It's the Yankees 7, the Rays nothing. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And that'll bring up the versatile center fielder Manuel Margot. Now the 1-1. Hit in the air to shallow center. Hicks is after it. He makes the catch. A great effort to get there and record the first out of the inning. And that'll bring up Joey Wendell. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. A little bit outside. 2 and 1. No runs, 3 hits, and no errors for Tampa Bay so far.
Too high.
Too high that time, and it's 3 and 1.
Team's been struggling on offense. Let your D work for you right here. Pound the zone.
Fastball too low, and that's ball 4.
Well, he walked him on 5 pitches, but that last pitch was really good. He missed down, but only by a hair. When a hitter has a 3-1 count, he can wait until he gets a pitch he loves.
Up next for the Rays, Willy Adames. He's 0 for 1 thus far. Now a throw over, and the runner back safely. Outside, 2 and 1. Kevin Kiermaier, the number 8 hitter here, waits on deck. The 3-1 finds the zone to fill the count, 3-2.
Helpful.
Wendell leads off first with one away. And he misses again. Ball 4. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on ball.
Well, they've struggled offensively in this one so far, but after that walk, they've got runners at first and second and look ready to make a little noise. Just need a big hit now.
So next to bat will be Kevin Kiermaier. Comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ballgame. 1-1. Runners are at first and second with one away. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball.
He's already walked 2 in this inning already. This guy just can't seem to find the strike zone.
Trying to send him packing for the second time. A swing and a miss for out number. Ball he had no chance of making contact with.
Boy, that's the best pitch in baseball. Right there, he strikes that elevated fastball. Every hitter thinks that, hey, they can do something with that, but most of the time, you get the result that you saw right there. A big swing and a miss, and another strikeout.
At the plate, Mike Zunino. Skied into straightaway right. Judge is under it. And that ends the inning. Rays strand a pair. They're down by a touchdown, 7-0. Colin McHugh, a 6'2" right-hander, jogs in to take over on the mound.
Number 31, Colin McHugh.
All set for the start of the inning, and stepping up as the shortstop, Gleyber Torres. McHugh offers up perhaps one of the nastiest sliders around, and it won't be uncommon to see a lot of off-balance swings against it, and it'll be easy to see why once you see it come out of his hand. He's got a huge break on it. Left center, base hit. Not every day that you see a ball come off the bat like that one did, and looking at it again on show track, we see it a lot faster than it came in. 113 miles an hour. Couldn't have hit that one much better than that. And now, Clint Frazier. Two balls and a strike. And action now in the Tampa Bay pen as it looks like a right-hander's begun to get loose. Nobody out, runner on first. Here now the 2-2. Ground ball to second. This could be two. To second for one. On to first, and they turn the double play. So here is Gio Urshela. He's one for two in this one.
Surprised that he goes back out away there on the mound. This is a count for a fastball challenge, and we'll see if he's ready for it in the box.
The 3-1 pitch. Now that's popped up.
Choi
is over to take a look, and no one will get this one. Fouled away. Curveball locks him up, strike three, and that's the third out. The Yanks held in check, and they hold a 7-0 lead. Welcome back for the bottom of the fifth. Here's Heidi Watney.
Matt, Rays manager Kevin Cash talked to me in between innings about his lineup's offensive production, and he really emphasized that they're not doing a very good job capitalizing on run scoring opportunities. He said it's tough to be successful when you can't find ways to get guys home, and while that's frustrating for everyone down here, he said sometimes you just have to move on. Move on to getting the job done next time. He also said they may try to focus on manufacturing more opportunities in traditional ways as opposed to sitting back and swinging, hoping that someone will come through with a big hit.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. Two and one to the Rays leadoff batter. And some action out in the Yankee bullpen now as a right-hander starts to loosen up. The 2-1. This is skied into short left center. Frazier comes on and makes the catch in shallow left for out number one. Next, here is Brandon Lau, one for two on his line so far in the game. One out, nobody on. And they're working the outer half here, but that one's wide for ball three.
Not a time to fool around right now on a 3-2 count with the middle part of the order coming up. Expect a good pitch to swing at.
Now the payoff pitch home. High in the air out to center field. Hicks is under it. Two down. Here's Randy Arozarena, 0 for 2 on his line thus far. Bases are empty here with two men out. And that one's taken outside for a ball to walk down. So no 1-2-3 inning here. They've got themselves a two-out base runner.
Well, they've been unable to get to this guy, so they'll take base runners any way they can get him. At the very least, you make him work from the stretch and add to his pitch total.
G-Man Choi the next to hit. He was sent packing on strikes in his last trip.
Yeah, Matty, and he was locked up by a good fastball for strike three last time. I'm interested to see if they attack him the same way. come at him with hard velo late or snap something off in the dirt to see if he'll fish.
Hey, struggling to find the release point of that curveball. That wasn't a very good one. Somehow he's just got to find that feel, because that's a pitch he's going to need going forward.
The 2-1. Now a fastball swung on and missed, and that is out number three. Rays strand just the one. They need to get something cooking here. It's 7-0. Top half of the sixth about to get started, and that'll bring up Gary Sanchez. A 2-2 count. Here's the pitch. And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning.
Classic slider down and away for the strikeout there. Not a whole lot to say about that pitch that hasn't been said a million times already. That's just a real tough pitch for a hitter to pick up out of a pitcher's hand, so they end up chasing when they're in protect mode.
So now to the plate, DJ LeMahieu. Timing just a tick off there as this one's fouled off to the right. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. To two balls and two strikes now.
And this guy's a grinder. Fouls off good pitches and doesn't seem to swing at the ones just off the corner. This guy's a pitcher's nightmare.
Now a swing and a fly ball. And he will make the play out there, and there are two away now. So a nice running catch on display that time as we get a look at it again with Showtrack. He took a nice route, covered a good amount of ground, 100 feet to be exact, to bring that one in. Well done. Standing in now, Aaron Judge. Oh, and here's a drive. Well hit out to straightaway center. Back goes Kiermaier. And it's gone as they add still another. A solo home run there for Aaron Judge. His second of the game as they've widened this lead to 8 now.
Well, he's obviously very comfortable in the spotlight here. In the postseason, everything is amplified. Runs mean more, and every pitch counts, especially when you make a mistake as bad as this one. Missed his location, and he takes it out of here in a heartbeat.
To the plate now, Aaron Hicks. Hit hard down the line, but this will be a foul ball as that evens things at 2-2.
Lucky he got a piece right there. He was definitely late on that pitch after seeing a previous off-speed pitch.
And the throw to first will indeed get him. It's a strikeout, score at 2-3, and the inning is over. But add on one more as the solo shot stretches their lead even further. On to the bottom of the sixth. It's the Yankees 8, the Rays nothing. And that'll bring up Margot. They'll get things started here in the second half of the sixth. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and it's 1-2. Double-barreled action in the Yankee bullpen now. A lefty and a right-hander start to get loose. Line drive to center field, and that's a base hit. 1-for-2 in his first couple of plate appearances. So it's a good start to the inning for the Rays as their leadoff hitter is aboard.
The third baseman, Joey Wendell.
At the plate now, Joey Wendell. High in the air down the right field line. Heading after it is Judge. And he makes the catch in the corner. Now to the plate here is Willie Adames. And he lays off upstairs, but it's ruled a strike, and he can't believe it. 1-2.
He's up to 100 pitches now, but he's still bringing the fastball pretty good. Nothing about that last throw tells me he's wearing down right now.
Margo, base runner at first with one out. Popped him up. Sanchez has a play. He's got it, and there are two down now.
Up next for Tampa Bay, the 17th.
Next to hit is Kevin Kiermaier. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. One and one, here it is. Lifted down the line and left. And foul. Two out with the man at first. And he struck him out, his seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. One left for Tampa. They're on the short end of an 8-0 score. Ryan Thompson comes on to pitch now, hoping for better results than the other arms that they've run out there in this one. Seventh inning ready to roll, and digging in is the veteran DH, Giancarlo Stanton. One misses for the second ball. The 2-1. And it's full 3-2. Luke Voigt waits on deck. Now the payoff pitch home. He swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
Leading off the inning, your job is to get on base and set the table for the inning. That was a pretty good at bat, and that he pushed the count to 3-2 and made the pitcher work. But I think he'd like to have that 3-2 pitch back. Pretty sure that was ball four he went after.
Stepping in now, Luke Voigt. Ground ball sent back up the middle. On to first, and there were two down. Out of bat, Gleyber Torres, 1-for-2 in the ball game thus far. Two out, nobody on. Swung on and hit deep to left center. This one has a chance, and it's gone as they add still another. So a solo shot here to left center field as they've pushed this lead up to 9 now.
Yeah, you could see he just made a mistake. He was cruising in the 7th, getting the first two outs, but then he offered up one that caught a little bit too much of the plate. This one got up and out of here, ruining what looked like a good appearance out of the bullpen.
Into the box now, Clint Frazier, hit in the air down the right field line. Margo's on the move. He's there to make the play, and that'll retire the side. Yanks able to add on one more via the solo home run. Bottom of the seventh inning coming up. Get up and stretch. It's the Yankees 9, the Rays nothing. Justin Wilson gets the call from the pen to take the ball for the home seventh.
Number 34, Justin Wilson.
Here now is Mike Zunino, 0 for 2 from him so far in this one. Pitch on its way now to Zunino.
Ball three.
Shin high fastball three that time. Ball three. Any part of that cutter, and it's full three
got
and two.
Full count.
Now the payoff pitch home. Ground ball right into the shift. Throw on to first in time, one away. One out now in the Tampa Bay seventh. Austin Meadows will be the next to bat. A little early, and now it's even at 2-2. Pitch on the way. This pitch is taken high and away to fill the count. It's 3-2. Brendan Lau is on deck. Making him sweat out there. The seventh pitch coming up. Lifted in the air out to right. Judge is under it. He hauls it in without any trouble. And there are two away. At the plate now is Brendan Lau. He's got a hit in three at bats to this point. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Very high, 2-1. And a fastball, but he's losing it a bit here. It's a 3-1 now. Bases are empty here with two men out. Not surprisingly here, this is on the ground to the right side. And that will conclude matters here in the seventh. Rays go in order, 1-2-3. They're looking up at a 9-0 deficit. Set to go as the third baseman, Gio Urshela. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. Gone to lead off the inning. So a solo shot here to left center field, his second home run of the series, as the blowout continues. These guys are really putting on a show here. That dinger brings the total up to 5 for the game so far. Amazing stuff today, guys.
Yeah, Matty, I love this, B-roll. You want to watch offense. You pick the right game to come and see.
5 bombs from one team. Everybody in the lineup. They're making fun right now to guys who don't have a homer in this one.
Chaz Rowe comes on to pitch now, hoping for better results than the other arms that they've run out there in this one. So now to the plate, Gary Sanchez.
Ball, that's out.
And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1. But this one almost in the books. The story was clearly the long ball. What are your thoughts on this offense, fellas?
Well, Matty V, I don't know what your thoughts are.
Now this one is blasted to left field, and there's no doubt about it. Back-to-back jacks. It's a solo shot here for Gary Sanchez. His second home run of the series as they just continue to pour it on here.
Another excellent swing right there. That's multiple home runs in the same inning. Watch yourself. You're missing over the heart of the plate.
Into the box, DJ LeMahieu. On the ground up the middle, and there's his first base hit in this one.
There's a hard hit ground ball. Pitcher not able to get a glove on it. Hard single up the middle.
Yeah, watch your lips right there, Dad. Sent it back right where it came from.
Aaron Judge coming to the plate again as we look back at his two home runs in the game so far. The most recent back in the sixth inning. Gets the sign. Here comes the 2-1. To turn two now.
Hey, you know in the back of your mind as a batter right here, he's got that nasty sinker. I know it's 0-2, but he might not be looking for the punch out. You have to find a way as a batter to get that two-seamer up in the zone, or you're going to ground into a double play.
A little late with the swing, but he stays alive. Still 2-2. LeMahieu aboard here at first with nobody out. Hard hit ball to second. That's through for a base hit, and he's putting together a monster line in this one. They just can't get him out. And they keep rolling here. Their runners at the corners with still nobody out.
Yeah, and I think this is the case of a guy trying to rush it, hoping to turn a double play. And instead of getting two outs, they get zero outs. And runners are on first and second.
In now, Aaron Hicks. And he misses with it. Ball four. So that'll load the bases. And now he's really going to need to get a ground ball.
I think he was trying to be a little too fine there. And a walk is the result. Well, the good news is he has a force at every base. The bad news, a single probably drives in a couple of runs.
Late now is the designated hitter, Giancarlo Stanton. Lifetime against this particular arm. A number of meetings, he's 1-for-7. A 1-1. Misses, ball two.
His pitch count is getting up there in the inning now. He needs to get this frame over with sooner than later, so forcing contact and getting the defense involved is probably the best thing he can do.
Bases loaded here, nobody out. Giancarlo swings, and this ball is hit well into left field. And that ball is out of here. It's a grand slam. So one swing, and he unloads the bases on that one, his second home run of the game, as this lead got even wider. So batting practice continues here today as they notch their seventh home run of the game.
Oh, Matty B, this has turned into a lopsided one here. How about this, D-Row? Seventh home run of this game alone.
This is crazy. They knew coming in they had the lineup to do damage, but this is getting absolutely out of hand right now. This guy is missing over the heart of the plate. This trend could continue.
Nick Anderson comes on to pitch now, hoping for better results than the other arms that they've run out there in this one. At the plate, Luke Voit. Fastball. Close, but he didn't get it. 2-1. A little too tall that time. 3-1 now. Hitters count all the way. Here it comes.
3-2.
There's the good fastball, and he can't catch up. 3-2.
He was able to sneak that fastball by him on 3-1, so now we've got a battle on our hands.
They really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out.
That's a pretty sad attempt at hitting a baseball right there. No doubt he was completely fooled because that was a curveball, and it looked like he was late on a curveball. That tells me he gave up on it right till the very end, and obviously there was nothing he could do at that point.
At the plate now, Gleyber Torres. And that one misses badly. It's ball two.
He might have to look for a different way to put this guy away on 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times. He might be looking for it.
The pitch. And a sinker dips too low there. Into the dirt, in fact. Clint Frazier will be next. Still only one out in the inning. He might have another one as this is hit high and deep out to left. But Rosarena is back to the track as he takes it for out number two. And now here is Clint Frazier struggling so far in this one and looking to erase his 0-for-4 ball game right here. He's set and the payoff pitch. Here's a little chopper up the middle. Adamas brings it in. On to first, and it's in time as they're finally able to retire him. But they manage to bat around as 9 men come to the plate and 6 of them score. Not too many more shots left. Home half of the 8th coming up. The Yankees lead it 15-0. Darren O'Day is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the 8th.
Number 56, Darren O'Day.
So now to the plate, Randy Arozarena, 0-for-2 for him to this point. Swing and a little tapper. The 2-2. And he sends it out of play. Another 2-2 offering. Just wear him down as this one swung on and missed for the first out.
Well, we've seen some really good pitching from these guys in this one. The bullpen has looked sharp and it backed up a nice effort turned in by the starter. These days, pitching has become a full staff effort, and I've been impressed with the job these guys have done so far.
To the plate now, G-Man Choi. Two balls and a strike to the Rays first baseman. Right-hander starts to loosen out in the bullpen now. Bases are empty, one man out. And that one yanked just foul. he's set. Here's the 2-2. And he fouls this one off. And he just misses inside with the fastball there.
These last two guys are making him work quite a bit out there. Both have been long at bats, and all in all, he's had to make 13 throws just to them so far.
One out, nobody on. And that misses for ball four.
Well, that was a slider in a 3-2 count, and it just didn't tempt him enough to get a good swing. A good job of pitch recognition and knowing the strike zone to draw the free pass there.
So now here is Manuel Margot, singled last time up. Here now the 2-2.
Not a bad time right here to put that runner in motion. 3-2 count. You send the runner, and if it's a bad pitch, it's ball four.
Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. Now a ball slapped hard the opposite way, but this will hang just long enough for him to run it down in shallow right for the second out.
Up next for Tampa Bay, the third baseman.
Up next, Joey Wendell flew out last time up. Fouled off. Here he comes again, 1-2, heading out towards shallow right. And 8 innings have come and gone now as the inning is over. Rays strand just the one. Start the bus. They're down 15-0. Urshela, who went deep last time up.
He got three and two.
A fastball and can't connect. 3-2. This pitch misses here. It's ball four, and they've got a leadoff base runner aboard to start the ninth.
Up next for the Yankees, the catcher.
Now at the plate is Gary Sanchez. His career numbers in this matchup, just a couple of matchups, no hits in two at-bats. The 1-1 is a ball down and away. The 2-1 pitch is laid off up for ball number three.
Got to find a way to get back in the zone. I know you're in danger of losing both to walks, but certainly don't miss over the heart of the plate and have this guy gap one, or even worse, hit a two-run homer.
Urshela gets his lead at first, nobody out. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. And he struck out again. That's the third time he's gone down on strikes in this one.
That's the third time in this game he's gone down on strikes. Not the game he was hoping to have when he was taking batting practice, but at least his guys are ahead.
Now, DJ LeMahieu. Good pitch there. Called a strike on the inside corner. Lays off 2-2 now.
Wow, that was a close pitch on 1-2. The count's now on 2-2, but boy, that one very easily could have been called strike three. Really close pitch.
Boggs now the pitch. Pulls this one in the air out to left. Rosarena is in his tracks now as he makes the catch for out number two. Here's big Aaron Judge. He reached on an error and later scored his last time up. Two.
So you'd love for him to offer at that one, but the execution was flawless. Nice curveball that starts in the zone and breaks just out. Just a great take by the batter.
Frozen on strike three for the final out of the inning. One left for the Yankees as they can't add to their slim 15-0 lead. Jonathan Loaisiga, 5'11", right-handed reliever, enters to take over on the mound now.
Number 43, Jonathan Loaisiga.
So now into the box is Willy Adames. He'll lead it off with his guys needing a ninth-inning rally here if they're going to force a game four. Now the 3-2 pitch. Hit on the ground to third. Scooped up. And there's one gone to start the bottom of the ninth. Next to dig in, Kevin Kiermaier struck out in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, Matty, he needs to clean it up. He's already got the hat trick. The boys are wondering if the golden sombrero is soon to follow. Gotta lock this AB in.
High fly ball out to straightaway center. Hicks on the move. He gets there, and that's the second out. Next up is Mike Zunino. And their season hangs in the balance here as they're down to their final out. The 1-1 pitch. Just a bit high with the fastball, but didn't get the call. Now the 2-1. And it's fouled away. Two out, nobody on. Tampa down to their final strike in this one. Popped him up. And the Yankees have cleared their first hurdle. They're headed to the AL Championship Series.
Well, they know their work is nowhere close to being finished, but they've handled their business so far, winning here to punch their ticket to the next round and a possible trip to the World Series. Well done.
For the left-hander Dan Plesac, Mark DeRosa, and our entire crew, this is Matt Vasgersian. This has been the American League Division Series.
Time for the ball game. 4 hours exactly.